Hey guys, I'm here with my first Halloween themed review. This is the first of possibly five, maybe six, that I'm going to try to have spaced out between now and Halloween. Here we have my very first NECA figure. This is the Cult Classics Hall of Fame Michael... Wait a minute. Is that what I think? You're not Michael... Who are you? Freddy! Freddy, get out of here! What'd you do with Michael? Where's Michael? Where is he? Where? Oh God. Michael, I'm sorry. I didn't know he stole your sheet, okay? I'm sorry. Michael, don't look at me like that. Michael, I'm so sorry. Okay, let's try this again. That was not Michael Myers before. I apologize, that is a little trickster I have in my room, and he is a video attention whore. So, we're going to start this fresh, and hopefully no more incidents. Here we have the NECA Hall of Fame Cult Classics Michael Myers. This is from a scene in the original Halloween, where, without going to the bathroom, Michael, I will cover that later, basically Michael is killing off babysitters. This is the night he came home type deal. And his latest victim... Babysitter, you know, the whole stereotype where she's got her boyfriend over and they're having some drinks and partying. Well, he kills the boyfriend and takes the sheets, putting on the boyfriend's glasses. And he comes into the scene and she's like, come on, what are you doing? Hello? Come on. And then he kills her. Really nice looking detail. My cat is curled up behind me in my chair. It's very cute. But here we have the packaging. This is my first NECA figure. I like him quite a bit. It's the night he came home. And this is from the original Halloween. This is not the Rob Zombie remake that I actually liked. Most people really didn't. He comes with a pumpkin, knife, and removable sheet. Well, that's good to know. Also in the set is the Crow, which I plan to get, and Captain Spaulding, which I already have. Very cool figure. I like him. On Halloween night in 1963, 6-year-old Michael Myers unexpectedly murdered his 17-year-old sister Judith. As a minor, Michael was sentenced to Smiths Grove Warren County Sanitarium, where he remained locked away for 15 years. On Halloween night, 1978, Michael Myers escaped from the sanitarium and returned home to Haddonfield to resume his murderous rampage. Yeah, basically, this kid just went nuts one night and killed his older sister. And in the newer version, he killed his stepfather as well. Or maybe it was his real father. I didn't really get the whole connection. But then in the sanitarium, he learns that his baby sister is still alive and living with a new family. So he returns to the original home of Haddonfield and pursues to kill her, or tries to kill her, played by Jamie Lee Curtis, who was Laurie Strode in the movie. Halloween 1 and 2... Well, Halloween 1 is a masterpiece. I love Halloween. Halloween 2 is, I think, just as good. It happens, it's a direct sequel, happens that night. If you want my opinion for the Halloween movies you should watch Halloween 1 and 2. Halloween 3, skip it entirely. It's not even about Michael Myers, there's no Dr. Loomis, nothing. Halloween 4 and 5 aren't bad. They're pretty good. Halloween 6, The Curse of Michael Myers, skip it, it is crap. And then Halloween 7 is Halloween H2O, and this brings the return of Jamie Lee Curtis as Laurie Strode. Very good movie. It's, I think, Halloween, the original, and then H2O are my two favorites. Halloween Resurrection, I wasn't a fan of. It does end the whole Laurie Strode saga of the movies, but it kind of ruins the whole premise of it. But anyway, onto the figure. Now onto the accessories. The pumpkin itself... looks pretty cool. I do have a complaint. Either they had originally planned the pumpkin to have a light-up feature inside, or this is from a different toy line that the pumpkin did have electronics, because if you look on the back of it, there is a battery cover. Now, when you take it apart, there's nothing but plastic in there. There's a little diagram that shows two batteries can fit in there, but there's no metal connectors to get the whole electricity flowing. Take the whole thing apart, there's no bulb in there. I think at some point, this was a light-up thing where you would push the stem of the pumpkin down, because it does go up and down, and it would turn a light on. I don't know why they scrapped the idea. I would have liked if this had a light inside of it. I thought, you know, I've actually thought about painting the inside yellow, so it would have a kind of a glow. But there are points off for having a pumpkin that was obviously made to have electronics and then just strip the whole thing out. I didn't like that. So, pumpkin aside, comes with this really, really nice little knife. It is pretty sharp. It feels fairly durable. It's a little bendy, so it's not going to snap easily. And I know it's hard to focus on that because it's so small. There you go. It's a pretty good little knife. Even has little details to show the blade being attached to the handle. I don't know if you can really pick up on that, but I thought it was a nice detail. Now on to the actual figure. Go ahead and zoom out just a teeny tad bit. This is a really good figure. My one problem with NECA is that while the figures have great detail, they look really good. They're pretty much statue. They have very limited articulation, and they're pretty much like McFarlane toys. At least from a lot of the figures I've seen, they look really good, but you can't pose them, and that does take serious points off for me. But anyway, you notice the sheet looks really good. It looks like an actual sheet. It's this nice rubbery material. The glasses can come off. I'm going to leave them on because if you've seen Slego's Legos' video of this exact figure, I don't even know what those are called. The side part of his glasses, I wear glasses and I don't know what those are called, breaks off very easily. But the glasses, I've really noticed, they actually have lenses. They're not just empty slots. And actually, I'm going to pull the glasses. I'm going to lie. I pulled the glasses off and a detail I thought was pretty cool is it lines up perfectly with Myers, where if you look into the eye holes, you can actually see his real eyes. And they actually look through the eye holes of the sheet. I thought that was a really cool touch. But let's pull the sheet off. One problem I had is there's some sort of glue or paint at the back there, and it held him on really tight to the figure. So when you pull this off, you're going to have to give it a pretty good tug. Don't worry, it's not going to break as far as I know. But yeah, the sheet looks really good, and it does fit other figures of this scale. Here we have Myers in all of his glory. I'm going to go ahead and give him his little pretty knife because Michael Myers needs his butcher knife. It is his chainsaw to his leather face. It's hard to say. Myers is really good, really nicely detailed. This is the jumpsuit he wore in the very first one. The mask looks really great. You can actually, like I said, with the sheet, you can see his eyes, which, there you go. And, you know, just like Slego's pointed out, in the right lighting, it makes as though he has the shadows for his eyes. Like, there's just evil behind them. Articulation-wise, he actually has more than I expected. His shoulders have a little joint where they can bend in and outwards. They can have a full movement all the way around. He has most of the NECA figures that I've seen have this really odd little joint in the elbow where it doesn't make sense to me. What is that for, you know, the broken arm look? I don't get that. Is that where Michael, you know, fell from a building and just shattered his elbow and it's just, Laurie, hello? I don't get that. It's pointless. It's just, why? Is that we're just going to be like, you know, big hug? I don't get it. But anyway, the detailing on his jumpsuit looks really, really good. I don't know if the light will... Yeah, not going to do much. You can't pick up the details on it. But it just looks ultimately really, really good. All the little seams, all the wrinkles, everything. The pockets. This is just a great all-around figure. Even to the point where you can... He actually has little fingernails. They are a bit dirty. They're dirty like mine. You can see the veins in his hands. He holds the knife very well. You can have it pointing upwards or downwards. I like to have it up like that. Arm has the same movement. His legs have no movement at all. I think you can bend his foot a little bit, but why? Because the pants kind of block it. His head can actually turn. It can turn all the way around, which I didn't expect. And you can actually have him look straight ahead or down as if he's sulking because somebody stole his sheet. You little troll. I'm going to get you later. But this is overall a really good figure. I think he is somewhat new. He has a little copyright stamp of 2004 on his foot, but on the back of his packaging it says 2008. So I think he is somewhat new. And I would highly recommend him if you are a fan of the original Halloween movies. or the new one. I like I said, I enjoyed the new Halloween one. It was a completely different take on Michael Myers, and I'm a fan of Rob Zombie from A House of a Thousand Corpses and all those, so I thought it was a pretty good feature. But trying to get his sheet back on here. You can pose him in the sheet holding his knife. It doesn't fit the form of the sheet as well as it should, but still, I think it does look kind of cool. It's just, he's got his little knife hanging out. Hey, baby. How you doing? But, yeah, glasses. Be careful with the glasses. They just slide right into little holes made in the sheet. And there you go. Michael Myers. Definitely recommend it. Pick it up if you can find it. This would be great to add to your Halloween collection. All right, guys. That's it. Video one is down. I'll see you around.